Right now, run a mentoring program for Sheboygan County called Strength Through Leadership. And the goal of the program is to teach the young men how to be independent, how to be positive in the community, and basically improve their quality of living.
For mentoring youth has grown. As a videographer, I decided to document a week in the life of Courtney Gavin.
My name is John Strader.
Yeah.
Pretty well. Like he made me think that trouble really isn't so worth it. Like he keeps me entertained after school, so I really got nothing bad to do. Home's a lot better. We had some really good talks about home. He's a pretty cool guy.
2 years ago, I did bad stuff like almost every day, and now I've like matured, and I'm not as bad anymore.
Well, now I don't get in trouble as much, and my grades have been improving in most of my classes.
Get me out of trouble when like it's school and everything.
Today we're working on making tostadas. Every Thursday we try to do something, different, something original. So today we're doing tostadas.
Courtney Gatlin from St. Louis, Missouri. Rough.
Yeah.
To put it lightly, yeah, rough. It was a lot of craziness happening. Well, growing up in St. Louis, I had a whole lot of mentors, but none of them good mentors, I'll tell you that. So I figured I can just take my misfortune and turn it into something positive, you know?
And explain to me about it.
When I said a lot of mentors, I looked up to a lot of people that they'd be kind of frowned upon if you're looking from the outside looking in. But, you know, given I was in that environment, it was mentors to me, you know? And it was the only thing I knew. So I figured, hey, since I got this knowledge that I know now that I didn't know back then, figured I'd give it back to some of the kids around here.
My name is DeJuan Gavlin from Chicago, Illinois. I think he's a good role model. You know, he try to do his best for kids even though they ain't his. Take us on trips, you know, do whatever to keep us out of trouble. He spend his own money on us. So I think that's a good thing.
Help you get out of trouble. Help you stay sober. Not to use drugs or alcohol.
Like when we first started group, we like kind of had a strong bond, like big brother, little brother, okay. Relationship like that. We like crack jokes on each other a lot and all that.
Like checking up on me. like what am I doing on the weekends and all that. And like, and like, he wants me to like get my grades up. Okay. So he does his best to like get my grades up.
Every single time kid leave group, I feel like I try to evaluate if I did a good enough job. We do have evaluations where we have to turn in every month. Well, I turn in every month daily, evaluating the kids and taking notes, seeing if they participated, if they what was their bright spots, what was their low spots of the day. So after seeing them grow for so long, it's real hard just let them go sometimes, especially when they got a little soft spot for them. And usually I end up having one for all of them, pretty much. Yeah, that's the question I ask myself every day.
I really stopped getting in trouble. I was on a lot of females. I calmed down. Stayed out of jail. I ain't been in jail since I left group.
If Mr. Gallen was around, I'd most likely be in jail right now or with my friends doing bad stuff.
I want to say for the upcoming new group members that Courtney is a real cool person, and I can't wait to meet you guys.
Look in the mirror and don't even recognize myself. Been getting better, but I could still use a lot of help. I wipe my eyes and wonder why can't I just help myself. My tears fall and turn my sink into a wishing well. I wonder where all of my friends they used to wish me well. And what happened to the days of never kiss and tell. I wanna go back to the day before I fell. When I was confident that I wasn't going to hell. Now I'm going through just trying to make it. I'm going crazy, wondering how much longer can I take it. Was told that I was chosen. Why do I feel